All right, everybody. I'm recording this so that at a future date, you can hop back on and watch it. And what we got is boom. For those of you that were watching, we got 4 pounds of unsalted sweet cream butter. I scooped this up at Costco. All right, just make sure you don't wear your weapons when you go there or make any furtive movements. Now, we also have 5.2 grams of Kief. Kief is basically the concentrated trichomes, dust powder, whatever you want to call it. For those that are uneducated, make sure you educate yourselves about Kief. I'm talking to you, law enforcement. Educate yourselves about what Kief is before you go making all silly, crazy assumptions. Kief is nothing more than dust or a pollen-like substance or a dust-like substance that falls off of a cannabis plant. It's not like some new crack form or something like that. So we got that. And what we're going to do is we got an empty pot. See? Empty pot. 4 pounds of butter. First thing we're doing, the first step. And all we have is a pot, this butter, and then we have the Kief, the 5.2 grams. And then we also have the other piece of machinery. And for me, this is the most important piece. Some of you might not have this. All you really need is a crock pot. As you can tell, I still have butter residue left in here from the last batch. See the butter that we're going to add in there on? It's because I always have butter made so I can, you know, toast, whatever. You know, I stay medicated. But we have this, which is a crock pot. And we're going to need that after we break everything down. So, let's get cracking. First things first. We're going to move the bananas. We're going to get this crock pot ready. All the dishes out of the way over here. All right, here we go. We're recording. The first step that we're going to do is we're going to take 4 pounds of butter. Each one of these blocks is a pound, okay? There's 4 blocks in the box. We're going to use 4 pounds of butter, 5.2 grams of Kief for a grand total of about 1.3 grams of Kief per pound of butter. So what we're going to do is we're going to peel open these kilos, these bows, these pounds, unwrap them. And all we're going to do is drop them in the pot, drop. Boom. We're going to drop those in. Go ahead and turn that on, get it going. And what we're going to do is we're going to melt this butter down and we're going to clarify it. That's the first thing we're going to do. So as you can see, let me tilt the camera down. You don't need to see me. You see the heat under the big pot, top of the pot. All we're doing is I'm dropping the butter in there right now. All right. Now, I'm not sure how long I can record for. Maybe it'll let me record this whole darn video. We're going to find out. So, but the first step, what we're doing now is we're just taking our 4 pounds of butter. We're dropping it in the pot. You guys watching? Call your friends, text them, Facebook them, let them know there's a dude right now online live showing people how to make very, very potent Kief butter without talking about how it does it. Everybody can ask Scouser. If Scouser's watching, ask him if the brownies and the all-day stuff I make is not fabulous. And I don't mean fabulous like just fabulous tasting. I mean fabulous in that, like when you go to a dispensary and they charge you 20 bucks for a brownie and you're like, what the fuck just happened? Well, here, I make the brownies because, well, I need them. I use them for me. And, well, I'm not going to make no weak bunk brownies. That's just not how I do it. And you'll see it doesn't take a lot. I have an herb box, and over the course of what I'm actually using as far as flour and smoking as far as herb, well, the Kief that comes off that through the pollen box gets saved. Nothing's wasted. So now we're going to, boom. We got 4 pounds of butter that we're putting in here. And the reason we're doing this too is also because now you're going to be able to know that you're watching me make this butter here. And next, you know, throughout the next few days, starting on Wednesday, I'm going to have edibles available. And licensed patients, I'm going to give them away for free because I want licensed patients to be able to try them and see that what you're getting and what you should be getting out of these dispensaries, places that are for the patients. Well, I want you to be able to hold them accountable, all right? Because they're going to be asking you for your support the same way that I do. And there's some places that earn it. And there's other places, well, that they just expect it because they think, oh, I'm open and I sell weed to people, so they should come support me. Nah, that ain't how it rolls. People, the only people that are going to end up supporting you and they're not going to do it publicly are going to be the people that were helping you, all right? Like the people that were trying to grow for you and stuff like that. And the only thing they're going to help you with is trying to find out what information you've told the people that are investigating yo ass. So, it's a dog-eat-dog world. I'm glad now that there's enough businesses out there that are screwing up Nevada law to where I won't even have to do it the right way anymore. I can go live right here to my kitchen. You know, I don't need business licenses hanging to do a live Ustream to show people how to make some butter. So right now, we got our butter. It's melting down. What we're going to do is we're going to clarify this butter. All right, so we've got it melting down, and what happens is, and I'll show it to you before I start pulling it off. As the butter melts, you begin to notice this, a white foam. You know, it's a real, and what it is it's basically the water that was trapped in the butter whenever it was hardened. So what we're doing is we're heating this butter up so that we can scoop this foam, or basically this water off. Because that's what happens when you melt the butter, you get that oily, and it's going to sit down. And then you're going to get this foam. And the foam is basically the water that's boiling, so to speak. And we're going to scoop that foam off so that we're left behind with just as much butter as possible. In other words, fat. We want all the fat. We don't want no water in there. THC is fat soluble, not water soluble. Okay? So you always want to remember that. Now, I'm not sure. Does anybody know if there's like time limits? Because I don't want this to stop recording. We miss it. I want to make sure we get the whole thing. But I also want people to understand this is 4 pounds of butter, just to give you an idea. Okay? 4 pounds of butter. So you know. You only need 2/3 of a cup of butter to make a box of brownies. And there is going to be way more than 2/3 of a cup of butter from this. 4 pounds of butter will make brownies and cupcakes for days. Cookies for days. Think about it like this. Most cookies call for one stick, all right, one stick of moistened or softened butter. Each one of these big blocks I threw in there is 4 sticks. So basically, I just showed you that you're going to be able to make 16 bags of cookies. If it calls for a stick of butter, 16 bags of those cookies, all right? So if you get 24 to 30 cookies per bag, all right, do the math. How many cookies is that? And people say, oh, do the math. I could sell those. If that thought comes into your mind about selling those cookies, boom, bad things are going to happen to you. It's just the karma with it. But now if you want to bag those cookies up and give them to patients that need them, boom. Blessed is he.